what are 5 reasons why diabetics stay diabetic? And how can you break the chains? We're about to reveal the 5 most common reasons why your diabetes has not gone away, and how you can overcome the factors which contribute to ever-increasing insulin resistance. Insulin resistance occurs for many reasons, some you may not have even heard about. Food sensitivities can cause inflammation in the body, which leads to insulin resistance. Nutrient deficiencies can impair glucose metabolism. Hormonal imbalances can affect blood sugar regulation. And even environmental toxins have been linked to an increased risk for developing type 2 diabetes. These same underlying issues are often responsible for other chronic illnesses as well, including autoimmune diseases and digestive disorders. That means addressing the root causes of insulin resistance could be the key to improving your overall health. But perhaps you are one of many type 2 diabetics who have struggled to break free from chronic high blood sugar. So, what are the main explanations for why your diabetes has not gone away, even after years of treatment? It's time to address the 5 biggest factors for why you may still be classified as diabetic. And we want to show you the proven steps you can take to finally end the vicious cycle of insulin resistance. Welcome to 5 Reasons Why Your Diabetes Hasn't Gone Away and How You Can Break the Chains. Insulin resistance is never a quick fix, which also signals that this condition develops over time. And that should be a clue as to the causes behind insulin resistance. But let's start with one factor which has been with you from the day you were born. Number 5. Genetics. A fact of life we can't escape is that our health is forever tied to the medical history of our forefathers and foremothers. Simply being genetically predisposed to developing type 2 diabetes is one thing. But did you know that you can also be genetically predisposed to suffering ever-increasing levels of insulin resistance? Certain genetic variants, like those associated with the PPARG gene, have been linked to a heightened risk of insulin resistance. It's also been found that certain genetic mutations can affect how the body processes glucose, which may make it inherently more difficult for some people to avoid blood sugar spikes. And even being of certain ethnic origins can also raise your risk for developing type 2 diabetes. For example, longitudinal studies suggest that those of African and Asian descent may be more prone to developing insulin resistance than those with European ancestry. So, no matter how hard you try, you may be predisposed to becoming type 2 diabetic, or you may have difficulty in lowering your blood sugar simply due to your family history or your ethnicity. However, you can still fight back against diabetes. What other factors that you can control may be behind your heightened glucose levels? Well, you should know about. Number 4. Medication side effects. You're probably aware that there is always a small risk of pretty much any medication causing unwanted side effects. And there are a list of pharmaceuticals which have been found to cause a rise in blood sugar. These include corticosteroids, which are typically prescribed to treat asthma or inflammation, but they may increase your liver's glucose production, which could lead to a drop in insulin sensitivity. Beta blockers are commonly prescribed to treat high blood pressure, but they can also interfere with your body's ability to utilize insulin effectively. You should also be mindful of diuretic medications, which are used to remove excess sodium and water from the body, but they can also reduce your body's potassium levels. This may create an increase of glucose in your bloodstream as well. Even certain antipsychotics, which are employed in the treatment of depression, bipolar disorder, and Alzheimer's disease, have been found to lead to weight gain, which can then lead to heightened insulin resistance. But ironically, did you know that a side effect of certain diabetes drugs is that they may also increase your insulin resistance? Thiazolidinediones, prescribed in the treatment of type 2 diabetes, initially work to increase the sensitivity of your cells to insulin, but they activate certain receptors associated with glucose metabolism, which may lead to an increase of fat storage, which may lead to weight gain. And weight gain in and of itself increases your risk of insulin resistance. At the same time, these diabetes medications can also create a decrease of glucose uptake. This too can heighten your insulin resistance over time. All told, this can result in heightened levels of glucose in your bloodstream, and ironically, an eventual decrease in your insulin sensitivity. But what if you do not currently take any prescription medications, and yet you are finding difficulty in lowering your insulin resistance? What else may be a cause of your chronic high blood sugar? Beware of number 3, prolonged stress. Everyone feels stress, and stress isn't always bad for you. In fact, scientists have identified a type of good stress, eustress, where hormones are released and your pulse quickens not because of an imminent threat, but because you are experiencing an exciting moment, like watching your team win a game or riding a roller coaster. Plus, research has shown that moderate levels of stress, in short spurts, can work to improve alertness, your performance, and your memory. Scientific studies have found that experiencing stress can create an increase of stem cells and neurons. That's how stress can help us learn from our past mistakes, so that we may avoid future dangers. But multiple studies have found that prolonged stress levels may lead to an increase of insulin resistance. That's because stress over long periods can force the body to produce heightened levels of cortisol, our stress hormone. And elevated cortisol levels have been shown to interfere with the body's cells and their ability to absorb insulin. In effect, having high levels of cortisol is directly linked to increased insulin resistance. Plus, it's been proven that stress can influence your satiety, hunger cravings, and your weight. Suffering from prolonged stress has been found to increase your risk of overconsuming high-fat and sugar-rich foods and drinks. And, of course, that too can increase your insulin resistance. Other studies show that prolonged stress can weaken your immune system, which can raise your risk of developing heart disease and type 2 diabetes. But what if you really do not have much stress in your life, and yet you still have high blood sugar? Well, while relaxation can be supremely beneficial for your body, you should also work to avoid number 2, a lack of physical activity. It's been proven conclusively that performing less physical activity can directly affect your insulin resistance. Of course, aerobic exercise, like jogging or cycling, can improve your cardiovascular health, which can help you to lose weight, thus reducing your insulin resistance. And anaerobic exercise, like weightlifting or other muscle-building routines, will make your muscle cells more receptive to insulin, thus increasing your insulin sensitivity. But being less active means your muscle cells will burn less glucose, which may leave excess glucose in your bloodstream. And if your body has become accustomed to physical activity but you start to avoid workouts, your muscle cells may have trouble adapting to this sudden increase of glucose in your bloodstream. The National Institutes of Health reports that long periods of physical inactivity and a general sedentary lifestyle can result in increased insulin resistance due to a lower energy expenditure, a dysregulation of lipid levels, and an increase of lipid storage, aka fat buildup. Studies have even found that sudden decreases in daily physical activities can create insulin resistance almost instantly. It's been reported that just 4 straight days of bed rest can lead to insulin resistance in adults. Similar studies have also found that adolescents may experience an increase in their insulin resistance after only 1 day of physical inactivity. So it may seem obvious, but it's certainly true for everyone, regardless of age or diabetes status. Getting less exercise can lead to an increase in your insulin resistance. Okay, so what is the number one reason why your diabetes has not gone away? The answer is just ahead. But real quick, let's get you those 3 free diabetes fighting gifts. Simply click the link in the description below and you'll receive the comprehensive guidebook, Superfoods for Diabetics, episode 1 of the groundbreaking series, That Diabetes Documentary, and the unique and easy-to-follow cookbook, snacks, meals, and desserts that lower blood sugar. Just click the link below to get all three for free. All right, it's time to reveal the number one reason why you may still have trouble lowering your insulin resistance. Number one, weight gain. Sure, this is sort of the all-encompassing answer behind heightened insulin resistance, as each of our previous four choices on this list are all related to weight gain. But it doesn't change the fact that weight gain, in general, is a main driver of increased insulin resistance. Of course, overconsuming high sugar foods on their own can create inflammation, which can heighten your insulin resistance, even if eating those foods doesn't cause you to gain weight. However, regularly consuming junk foods will most likely lead to some amount of weight gain. But even if you are mindful of what you eat, you can still gain weight based on how much you eat. Even overconsuming fruits, vegetables, nuts, and seeds can cause your body to develop more abdominal fat and intramyocellular fat, or fatty deposits within your muscle cells. And when your body stores more fat, specifically intramyocellular fat, it naturally becomes less sensitive to insulin. And that means your body will need to create higher levels of insulin to process the glucose you consume. For one thing, this can put extra pressure on your pancreas, but it can also lead to an excess of insulin in your bloodstream. Over time, this can make your muscle cells less receptive to your insulin, which can further contribute to weight gain. It's a vicious cycle. Putting on weight can also have the effect of increasing your risk of high blood pressure and elevated cholesterol levels. It may also create increased difficulty in breathing and sleeping. All of that may lead to an increase in your stress levels, which may also create increased insulin resistance. Studies show that gaining weight can also lead to feelings of exhaustion and depression, which may then contribute to a decrease of physical activity. And as we already showed, reducing your physical activity or becoming more sedentary will also raise your insulin resistance. So it's important to remember, even if you address the other root causes of insulin resistance and you adhere to a balanced diet, simply gaining weight will very likely lead to an increase in your insulin resistance. So, now that you can see the main drivers behind your insulin resistance, you can probably guess the major tools at your disposal for improving your insulin sensitivity. Number one, know your family's medical history, so you can understand if you are at an increased risk of type 2 diabetes. Number two, get a clear understanding of the potential side effects for your prescription medications, and adjust your lifestyle accordingly. Number three, actively work to reduce your stress levels, especially if you feel that you suffer from prolonged periods of stress. This may mean making leisurely walks a part of your normal routine, or you can find success with mindfulness techniques like yoga or meditation. Number four, be sure to take that daily walk and consider implementing other physical activities into your everyday life. Number five, utilize all of your knowledge and willpower to avoid gaining weight. It is difficult for everyone, especially as we age, but losing weight or even simply maintaining a healthy weight can make a massive positive difference for your blood sugar control. So, what did you think of today's video? How do you find success in fighting diabetes? Comment below so that others in need can gain your valuable insights. Please do us a favor by clicking the like and subscribe buttons. And to show your further support for Diabetes Smarts, you can click the thanks button. And before you head out, don't forget to grab your three free gifts. Just click the link in the description box below to get them all totally free. Thanks for watching. Please have yourself a diabetes-fighting day.